Hi guys, how are you today? Arina Shevchenko is here, your Facebook group visibility coach, marketing strategist, and founder of Savvy Action Taker Entrepreneur Academy. So if you're new to me, make sure you like my Facebook business page and join my Facebook group Savvy Action Taker Savvy Action Takers. However, today is the day number 3 of Content Creation Challenge. So today we are going to talk about how to deliver your content. Many of you create the content, many of you sharing out the content over the place, many of you create the content but don't get really awesome results with your content. So this challenge is helping you to create your content. Hey beautiful, how are you today? So here is this challenge is for you to create your content, to learn how to stay consistent with your content and learn what kind of mistakes you need to avoid when you create your content if you want to get results with your content. So if you're working on a mission to, for example, grow your followers, you know, build your visibility, sell your product, this is challenge is for you. So thank you so much for the likes, I deeply appreciate it. And make sure if you want to be a winner of this challenge, if you want to be the winner of the challenge, few things you need to do. First of all, share the video out. Hey beautiful, happy to see you. Thank you so much for joining here. Share the video out. Yes, sharing and caring. So simple like that, sharing is caring. So this is the one. The two things, the second part, what you need to know, you need to tag your bestie, best friend, somebody who you know that this challenge, this training would be helpful. As well, I deeply appreciate that. And the third part, you need to do the homework, because as we know, we all know that I'm action taker entrepreneur. I encourage you to take the actions because I deeply believe that when you take the actions, you're going to get results. Remember, it's no failing in your actions. It's no failing in your business. Lots of time people say like, it's okay, you know, if you fail many times or if you fail one time, put yourself together and continue to do it. No. My psychology behind the failing is totally different than most people. Maybe because I fail too many times. But the coolest part that I truly believe it's no failing. Every step that you're taking in your business, and if you take some steps and it didn't work, most people say it's failing. I'm thinking that it is your experience. That's how you learn what is working, what is not working. Lots of time people actually join my academy. You know, people join my academy, people follow me on social media. Lots of time people join my free training and they're like, oh my God, this is awesome. And the reason why people pay me for my experience, because long time ago I fell. Every time when I did something, I fell. So for example, I run the challenge and nobody participated in the challenge. I fell, but when I fell, I learned what needed to be twisted, what needed to be changed to improve it. And step by step, I was changing and changing and improving. And then I get results that I have right now. And right now I'm running my business from home, you know, totally six-figure business from home, helping other women out there to, you know, start running their business. So it's no failing on social media. Every time when you fail, you get experience. And in the future, if you don't give up, of course, in the future, you get pay for your experience. Yeah, it's a feedback. And it's totally, you get pay for your experience because this is how you become unique in your business. Every time when I fail, I learn something, I analyze your work, which is I always encourage you, learn, implement, and analyze. It's a golden rule that I use in my business. It's a golden rule that I teach my clients to do it. But that's how, you know, you grow. You learn something new, you implement that because you take the actions, right? You implement that and then you analyze, because you don't want to just take the actions not very smart way. You want to take the actions smart way. You know, you need to figure out what's working, what's not working. That is the analyze stage. And when you analyze and you look back and you're like, this is what's working, this is what's not working, and you focus in only on the working part, then you get results. Simple like this. So that's it. I don't even know how I came to this point, but the point is, if you guys want to be the winner of the challenge, make sure you share the video out, tag your bestie or somebody who you know that this challenge would be helpful for you, for that person. Join our Facebook group, Savvy Action Taker Entrepreneur, and under day three, do your homework, because I want to see you're taking the actions. I want to see that you finish this challenge with the words like, hell yeah, I completed, I commit to do the work, I completed, and I got results. Simple like this. This is results is for you, not for me. So do the work. And then the person who will do complete all these three parts, that person will get, I think it's 60% off of the academy. So our academy, Savvy Action Taker Entrepreneur Academy, which is you hear by now, you hear a lot, is $59 per month. Inside of the academy, you have different courses from basically, I'll be honest, from the beginning of your journey when you just started your running your coaching business to the six figure. Every step, everything would, you know, everything what you need. We have monthly coaching calls, we have guest speakers, but we have lots of courses inside itself that you go over course and you do whatever you need to do to take your business to the six figure. And so monthly payment is 59 months per month, and for the winner of the challenge will pay only $24, which is kind of stealing. Stealing. We have the courses, we have the workbooks, the cheat sheets, templates, everything what you need to succeed in your business, everything. Okay, so let's hop in and talk about delivery method. So today is the day two, three. So let's quickly recap. Day number one, we came up with the topics that you're gonna show up on social media and position yourself as an expert. Also, for those people who did the homework, I kind of help you with creating that powerful statement. You're gonna show up and be unique and kind of stand out in the crowd, position you as an expert. On a day number two, we set the goal for your content, because you don't want to just create the content and share your content without the goal behind. You really always need to have the goal. And for those people who took the actions and shared the goals with me, I was correcting you, because I found that some people actually slightly confused between the goal and the type of the content. So I was correcting you guys, helping you, giving you feedback to actually set and focus on the goal, not on the delivery method. And so we set the goal for your content. So now you know what kind of content to share, you know how to show up, and you know what kind of goal you have behind of your content if you want to achieve some kind of goal in your business, right? And today is the day when we will focus in on delivering your content. So I want to share with you a couple of tips that helped me to grow my business literally from scratch at the beginning. So the biggest mistake that I see that people make when we create content and deliver the content, we want to be, especially new coaches, we want to be over the place. We want to grow fast, and we want to grow on the go fast. We want to, you know, finding clients fast. We just want everything and now. Unfortunately, that's not working. So I found that when I do million things at the same time, at the end of the day, nothing is done. So we don't want that you get overwhelmed with your content. So I would encourage you, choose one or two platforms for your business, and you're gonna dominate that platform. So in my case, when I start running my business at the beginning, my platform that I was choosing, it was Facebook. Facebook and Facebook groups at the platform, basically one platform that I was choosing, and I put so much effort to build my community, to, you know, to put effort to attract people, to create income with that platform. And then when I created income, when I get my passive income, when I get my clients, then I figure out that when I look back, I see that my platform, my Facebook, is working for me, not I'm working for my Facebook, you know? And so what I want you to do, the same, guys, choose one or two platform. And right now, when I reach specific income in my business, I'm really happy. now I'm actually spreading it to the next platform. My next platform in my for 2018 is a YouTube and blogging. And I put the effort to build my YouTube account. I put the effort to create a blog that would be, you know, epic blogs out there. It doesn't happen overnight. So what I would encourage you guys, don't, that's the biggest mistakes that people do. They like, okay, I'm gonna be over the place with, you know, with my content. That strategy was working maybe a year or two ago. It doesn't work right now. Right now, like the before, like people was like, I'm gonna do Instagram, I'm gonna do Facebook, I'm gonna do YouTube, I'm gonna blog in, I'm gonna do LinkedIn, what else, Twitter, and over the place. And if you do your business by yourself, it's really, really hard. I will be honest with you. It's very, very hard to stay consistent for each platform. Each platform is different. I'm gonna give you example. Twitter, you have to tweet stuff. I don't remember. I think it's like 8 to 15 times a day. Blogging, well, it depends how often you blog, depends how much time you do, but it's like at least one blog a week or couple blogs a month. YouTube, like the more consistent you upload the videos, at least one video per day, then more YouTube will start actually promoting you. So you have to at least one video per day uploading out there. Facebook, at the beginning, like not now, but at the beginning people say it's like, you know, you need to put your content at least 3 times a day to be visible. You see, like if you find those social media platforms and you decide to do all those social media platforms at the same time, like Twittering 15 times per day, blogging at least one blog a week, you know, it's creating to blog, to write the content. I don't know if you add the videos to the blog, it takes time. Doing YouTube, uploading one video per day. Usually you don't just upload the video per day, you know, you want to do editing, making sure it's a professional way. Creating content to share 3 times on YouTube, on Facebook. It's hard and it's impossible. So couple years ago, do often was working. Right now, because it's so much noise on all social media, you don't want to create that noise. You want to choose one or two platforms that you consistently show up on those platforms, and you don't deliver lots of content, you deliver the epic content. That sometimes your content will be the best content, you know, better than everybody else. And yesterday we were kind of slightly was talking about how to create that unique content. So if you missed the video from yesterday, you still can watch replay, or you can like link above, I will add it, sign for the challenge, and at the end of the challenge I will be actually sending you email with all the videos out there. After that it will be taken down. So the goal number one, the golden number one, stop creating million contents, choose one or two platform for your business and dominate that platform, become the best person in that platform. What my goal, like specifically what I do use in my business, I actually create the content and make sure that I start in, you know, I create its organic content, then I make sure that I create passive content, then I make sure that my content start bringing me, you know, grow my list, that bringing me passive income, attracting new followers without me consistently hustling on that. And when I see that platform is working for me, not I am working for that platform, then I can move to the next platform. Usually in my business it takes up to 6 months, 1 year, sometimes that I start the platform totally from scratch and working to the point when that platform is actually working for me. Does that make sense, guys? Does it make sense that choosing one platform and make sure that start working to, you know, grow your followers, make sure that platform is helping you to grow your list, grow your followers, bringing you passive income, and then you can like spread your word to the next platform. Does that make sense, guys? Comment below, so say yes, please. Nobody cares. Thank you, Anna. Thank you so much. Because nobody cares, looks like. So this is the tip number one, guys. Choose one or two platforms and then do it. Yes, Katie is here. Awesome, definitely. That is not this. Okay, perfect. So this is one thing. The second thing, guys, now I want you to look at you. That's very, very important. The next step is look at you and figure out where you better. Are you good with writing content or are you good to do videos? Which one is the better? Like, I give you example. When I started my business, I was really afraid to show up on the camera and do videos. It was not the options for me. It was a huge block on my way and it just was not the options. It slowly I overcome my block. So, which is right now I'm on the videos all the time, but at the beginning it was really hard. And still I wanted to write the videos, you know, I want to write my content, my building my business, and it was really hard. So at the beginning of my journey, writing content was better for me than actually do the videos. Right now it's like 50-50, but I know some of my clients, they cannot do the videos, they just like, I cannot do the videos, I'm not there yet. So they're really good with writing content. Another thing, copywriters, they mostly good with the writing content than do the videos. Other people like confident coaches, they really good with doing the videos and they just kind of like it's sucking their time to write the content. So what now I want you to do, guys, figure out which you better, writing content or do the videos. Which of these are more close to you? And based on the answer, then you will figure out which platform, social media platform, is good for you. If you're good with blogging, if you're good with writing and the videos at the same time, good for you. Like, seriously, it's freaking awesome. Then you're like a step ahead than most people. If you're not there yet, then I would encourage you kind of grow you to become that way. But right now I want you to figure out which is better for you, writing or do the videos. If you feel comfortable to do the videos, then platforms like YouTube platform, Facebook, YouTube, Facebook, those platforms like Instagram, those platforms are great for you because Instagram has videos as well lately. Those platforms are great for you. So I would recommend you dominate those platforms. So for example, if I do the videos all the time on the go and then I don't have problems to do the videos, obviously it would be logically for me to go to YouTube, and because YouTube, it's all about videos, right? And do the, right now you can do live videos on YouTube, Facebook. You can do live videos on Facebook. And I would literally dominate that platform because it's no brain for me to create the video. Right? Hey, beautiful, how are you today? Welcome to the training. If I, for example, video is a letter for, oh, okay. Okay, so here is the deal. Videos is easier for you, but it's a little scary. That means you don't have enough practice doing the video. If I would be your coach, I would be like, girl, seriously, that's that kind of language I use. But I will be like, girl, seriously, commit to yourself, do the videos. Because if it's a little scary, that is means you don't practice it enough. That means you have your comfort zone and you're really like close to leave your comfort zone, but you're not leaving you're not stretching your comfort zone. Just thinking about like this, at the end of your journey, at the end of the day, you want to create the business that would be easy for you, that would be working for you. Yes, you have to put some effort to come to that point in your business, but you have to like that your business, it will be not like your 9-to-5 that you kind of like hustling with that hope that everything will be okay, you know? So when you know that videos are great for you, it's easy for you, but if something's holding you to do that, just overcome your own scary part. And overcome your scary part is that means you need just more practice. So in your case, I would be literally grab, commit to do the work, commit, stretch your comfort zone. And I would grab the calendar and I would be like literally commit 1 month to show up and do the videos. Like every like couple times a week, do the videos. So for example, if I want to like stretch myself and I know the video is better for me, but it's not comfortable, then I would be like, okay, this is days I can do, because consistency is important, and this is days like I will do like Monday and Wednesday I'm gonna do the videos, and I would push myself to take the actions. I guarantee at the beginning of your journey with this commitment, first of all, the first moment you will be like, yeah, I can do it, it's so exciting. Then you will be like, oh my gosh, I have to do it. And then you just like I cannot do it, it's scary as hell, you know, like it's like I cannot do it. You're gonna push yourself, like your brain will be like, no, living comfort zone is hard, I'm going to like stay inside of the comfort zone. Push yourself to leave your comfort zone. Remind yourself, this is where the mindset is coming. Remind yourself that you want to grow your business. You want to spread your word and actually help other people out there. Why would you kill yourself to create and writing content? You would literally push yourself and do it. Something that not, you know, not good for you, like videos more easy for you. Why would you do something that takes more time than you could do the something that easy for you, but you're holding yourself back? Yeah, you have to stretch yourself. You have to, this is the mindset. And guys, when we're talking about the mindset, I'm not the mindset coach, and I will be honest with you. I cannot find beautiful words like encourage you to do. I'm very simple and I'm very straight to the point. You have like, this is where you're at right now here. This is where you want to be. This is the road between you, where you're at right now. This is where you want to be. And every time when you make decision, your decisions is coming, and your decisions coming like, okay, I make decision to do the videos, and you take the actions to do the videos, you one step close to this where you want to be. If you make decisions, yes, I want to do the videos, but you're not doing the videos, you end up here. So you actually honestly ask yourself where you want to be, here or here, and then your actions is reflecting your results. Or results reflecting your actions, something like this. But basically, it's very, very like this. You're taking the actions. Yes, I want to do it, and you do it. You one step close to your dream. Or like, yes, I want to do it, but I'm not gonna do it today. You stay at the place where you want to be, where you at right now, which is where you don't want to be. Very, very like this. So in this case, I would be like, okay, that's how I did. In my business, when I start running my business, nobody would believe. I actually have in our Facebook group, I have the video at the beginning when I was doing the videos. It was horrible. Like everybody would never believe that I was suck in front of the camera. It was disaster. And I had so much strong block that, you know, when you do the presentation, you just have the presentation and you literally speak behind of the presentation. I could not even do that kind of presentation. I would put my presentation on social media, record it, and I put it, and I could not even leave it for 2 hours out there because I had the strong block. Oh my gosh, people are gonna listen to me. I have the strong accent. People will freak out. They will not like me. My English is not perfect. And I literally would put my presentation on social media and take it down within 2 hours. For me to leave my presentation for 24 hours so people actually can hear just my voice, not even see me. They would hear my voice only for 24 hours. It was the hardest moment ever. I will be honest with you. I literally had to put my presentation on social media, going to work for 16 hours because I know during the work time I don't have time to come back and delete it. So I leave my phone at home, I'm going to work, so I could not reach my phone. And when I come back from work, then I'll take lots of sleeping pills and I go to sleep. And I'm like literally just hold myself away from my phone and from my computer so I could come back and delete it. It was like that very bad. I would torture my brain. It was hard. And I remember when I finally overcome that step, when I'm like, I can put my presentation out there and kind of okay that people hear my voice. Then my next step was like, okay, I'm going to do the challenges. And I did the challenge. I think it was challenge, 7 day challenge. And I committed myself to do the 7 days, show up on social media and literally deliver the value. It was the hardest moment because I committed to do the work. But when you like have those blocks on your way, I would do my hair for 3 hours. I would put my makeup for 3 hours. It was like in the time when it's for me to do the, you know, show up on social media, I would find a million reasons why I don't want to do it. And because my commitment was so strong, I was like, I'm going to do it. And the first couple days, like, it's good, I can do it. And the second, like, I remember I was committed to do the videos at 1 o'clock p.m. The second day is the day after when I have, like, strong blocks, like, oh my gosh, I cannot do it, I cannot do it. Like, my videos, I show up not at 1 o'clock, I show up, like, at 3 o'clock. And some of the videos, I was remember that I was, like, I have to do it, you know, I still in the 7 days, I have to do it. And some of the videos I was did like at the end of the day, because all day I was like, I have to do it, but I cannot, you know. But I was pushing myself, do something that I didn't want to do. And when I did that, look at me right now. I own the videos all the time, I have no fears, I'm just hopping in and just do the work, right? Simple like this. But I would not come to this point if I would not committed, first of all, make commitment to do the work and with specific time. In my case, it was like 1 week, like every day I was committing. And like, if you cannot do it every day, do it, like commit to do it every month and couple times a week. And so this is the first one. I committed to do the work and I remind myself where I am, where I want to be. And every time when I do those steps, which step I do? Toward my back, like step back, or my future. And so this specific formula, I would say like this, was working great for me. If you would see me before and now, you would be like, Jesus girl, you like literally killing. Like you're doing great job. Like I would never believe that you have this kind of struggles. So commit to do work, ask yourself, find the way, like remind yourself why you do it, why you want to grow your business. Remind yourself that your business is not a hobby. You know, yes, when you like right now, when I'm running my business working for me, my income is coming. While I'm chatting here with you, I still get pay. Not from you, but I get my passive income pay, my regular pays, you know, like I get pay. Like I can take a day off and I don't have to struggle and where's my next client coming from. At the beginning of my journey, yeah, I didn't have none of it. Right now, I have no problems like take the day off and enjoy my life just because my business is working for me. But if I would not push myself to do the work, I would not be where I am right now. So I would encourage you guys to do the same. Katie says that she loves writing. So when you guys writing, so this is your choice now about the videos. You're done with the videos, right? If you do the videos, you know that videos is great for you. Choose the platforms that require videos. YouTube, Facebook, those platforms, the videos, right? And dominate that platforms. Share your content out there. It doesn't matter which platform you're going to use. The main goal that you want with your platform, the main goal that you want to grow your list, you want to grow your followers. It doesn't matter where, Facebook, YouTube, Instagram, you want to grow followers on that platform, you want that people grow your list with that platform, and you want to have income with that platform. Simple like that, right? You don't need nothing else. So you choose the platform that would be great for you. If you do videos, you know, figure out the platform that actually good with videos and dominate that platform. Put like 6 months of work, 6 months to 1 year of work, just to make that happen and make sure at the end of your that period of the time that platform is freaking you, killing that platform, is working for you. If you are writing, like if writing content is great for you, like you don't do the videos, but the writing part, you're genius with that. Do blogging. Blogging is, you know, you can write the blog. As also Facebook. Facebook groups, writing content works very well. If you want to put the effort, be a guest speaker, you know, that's writing blogs, the, how to say that correctly, but the guest speakers, contributions, like reach out those magazines, top magazines, that and you start writing blogs for those people. Also grow your business, also grow your list, you know, and then you just sell your product to those people who sign to your list or start following you. But choose those platforms that writing part platforms. LinkedIn is also really great for writing platforms. So blogging, LinkedIn, Pinterest. Pinterest is great. Yes, Pinterest is a visual aspect. That means you write the blog and you just create really awesome, very awesome graphic to that. And in our academy, Katie, I know that you're in our academy, you learn already that what, how to create the graphic and, you know, what the keywords you need to put on the graphic to grab people's attentions. But choose the platforms that the writing part is dominated. Like on YouTube, it's no writing part out there. It's descriptions only. YouTube, it's video dominated. LinkedIn, Facebook. Facebook is like 50-50 videos and and the writing one. Blogging, be a guest speaker of the blogger. those kind of, you know, actions. Grow your business and dominate those platforms. Choose one or two platforms and literally dominate those platforms. So that's when we're talking about, look at yourself, the tip number two, look at yourself, figure out where you're good with videos or you're good with the writing part, and then ask yourself, if it's video, which platform would fit in to the video part, if it's writing, which platform choosing to the writing part, and choose the, from that list, choose like one or two platforms that you like, you know that you're gonna dominate it and do the work. Depends. It's coming from how much free time you have. If I have lots of free time, I'm working from home, I have no problems. So then it's no problem for me to choose like two or three platforms. If I have a teamwork, I have like VA who would do the work repurposing my content, then I can share, take more than two platforms. If I do, like for example, I do everything by myself, I would like one platform and like literally focus on that platform. Don't make decisions like over the night. Or I share one or two videos on YouTube and things are not working. Or for example, I went to YouTube, I purchased some YouTube course and I did what they asked me. Within a week, I didn't get results. Things not working that way, guys. Seriously, it takes time to make things happen. You cannot grow your six-figure business over the night. It's just impossible. So do the work. I remember the golden rule that I use it and I teach my clients is implement, learn, implement, analyze. It doesn't, you cannot learn, implement, and analyze within like one day. It's just impossible. So choose one platform, two platforms, dominate that, test things out, figure out what's working or not work, what's not working, and focus on the things that are working and keep doing that. Grow your list, grow your followers, and make sales. Another thing, let's talk about delivering part and repurposing. So when you do the videos, a podcast also can be videos and podcast can be audio. So when, for example, you do the podcast, if you podcast is very easy. If you do the videos, you just separate video from the audio, and guess what? Audio goes to the podcast, video goes to, for example, YouTube. So what I do, I actually take one platform, I'm like, I'm good with videos, I choose YouTube as my main platform, I deliver the content out there, but I repurpose my content by separating like video and audio and upload it on your podcast. So in this case, I kill in like two birds at one time, I don't know how to say that. Does that make sense, guys? Tell me if it makes sense. Another thing, in our academy, I teach you guys to grow your list and make sales with webinars, challenges, you know, so creating your product and selling your product. So for example, if you know, for example, in my case, I know the challenge is working really great for me. I absolutely love to do that, but I know at the same time, webinars are not working for me. Just not working for me. So how I do that? I usually do challenges and then I repurpose in my challenges. I repurpose my challenges in a couple of ways. I can take down the challenge and can sell it. I deliver so much free awesome content on the challenge, so it's no problem for me to sell it. I can actually take down the challenge and chop it into pieces and dominate my YouTube account because I'm working to grow my YouTube account. So I take the challenge during each video on the challenge, I shared more than one tips. So I can chop it into pieces, from one video, usually it's like 1 hour video, from one video I create many, many small videos, and I literally schedule on YouTube. Boom, done. For example, the same with the webinars. When you do the webinars, you can repurpose in that. Webinars, guys, and I covered that in our academy, but webinars, when you deliver the content on the webinar, you usually have like about 3 main tips that you're sharing on a webinar, because at the end of the day, you don't want to make webinar longer than 1 or 2 hours, you know? You don't want to make it extremely long because people are not going to stay. And you don't want to make it too short because you still need to kind of build this know, like, and trust with your story, because you have to share your story, but with your content as well. So you have like at least around like 3 tips that you share on the webinar. You can chop it into pieces, and you can actually, like, for example, in my case, I would take YouTube and I like schedule those mini videos out there. Another thing, like challenges, webinars, what I can do blogs, but V blogs, like video blogs. So video blogs, it's basically I would create the epic content writing part, but I also would add the videos. One of my blog that I did a couple months ago, this is exactly what I did. I took the challenge down, I chop up the things that I think it's not necessary in that specific video, and then I create the blog step by step what to do and how to do to create your, I think it was on the challenge, to create your challenge. And I literally break it down. So I have text and video. So when you choose the platform, social media platform, like, you know, whatever, videos, blogs, LinkedIn, YouTube, Facebook, I keep looking on the site because my Facebook is open out there. Facebook, I choose those platforms. Then I ask delivery method. What kind of delivery method I'm gonna use to, for example, remember the goal we set on yesterday? Like, for example, my goal is grow my list, just for example. And then how I'm going to grow my list. I'm gonna use the videos, I'm gonna use the challenges, maybe I'm gonna use like some mini training, so whatever I choose the delivery content. And then I ask myself how I'm going to repurpose that to make sure that that platform that I choose, how I'm gonna stay consistent with that content. So what I want you to do, guys, 3 things for today that I want you to do. First of all, go to our Facebook group, Savvy Action Tech Entrepreneur, and under the day number 3, share with me the platform that you're going to use in your business. Whatever it is, close to videos or close to the text. Look at all the platforms in our academy. For those students who are in our academy, I kind of break it down out there. We have the training when I break it down like about writing part and videos, and choose the platform that you're going to use in your business. This is number 1. Make sure you're going to use it, and at least you give yourself like 6 months at least to make sure that that platform is working for you. Then figure out delivery method. How are you going to deliver? You're going to write the blogs, or you're going to be like writing blogs. If, for example, if it's writing blogs, it will be text and video, or it will be just video, or it will be just text. Whatever it is, choose the delivery method that you're going to use with that platform. Okay. So that's what I want you to do, guys. Get delivery method. Figure out how you're going to repurpose your, like if you deliver, you create one content. How you're gonna repurpose that content? What's the goal behind of that content? Get clear on those small aspects under your content, okay? Any other questions related to this part? Waiting for the questions. Okay, so this is your homework for today. Choose the platforms, share with me the platforms, and tell me how you're gonna deliver your content and how you're gonna repurpose your content. And tomorrow is the day number 4, which is, I'm very excited, because tomorrow we're gonna map up your content. If you want to prepare for tomorrow, please make sure that you have some kind of, I'm gonna share with you, some kind of calendar in front of you. In the workbook, I actually, guys, in the workbook for tomorrow, I kind of like write it down like week like with number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. But what I would encourage you, if you really want to prepare for tomorrow, here is, let me open the empty calendar for me, for you. Okay, empty calendar. So for tomorrow, for example, I'm going to give you part of this. No questions for now. Perfect. So for tomorrow, prepare your calendar. So to grab the calendar. In my case, it's actually a big one. Like this. The whole month calendar. But grab the calendar for whole month. Some people like the printable way. Some people like to use Google Calendar, whatever it is. Just grab it for tomorrow, because we're literally going to mapping up your content for, you know, for whole months ahead. By tomorrow, which is, you're gonna do it today, by tomorrow you already will know what kind of platform you're gonna use, you already will know what kind of content you're gonna share, you're gonna know how you're gonna share this video, text, you know, how you're gonna repurpose that, you know, all those small aspects. So by tomorrow you will have all that big picture. Okay guys, so if you have questions, you are welcome to share it in our Facebook group, Savvy Action Tech Entrepreneur, under the day number 3. Otherwise, I want to look forward to see your homework, look forward to see what kind of platform you're going to share, how the delivery method, like videos, text, audio, whatever it is, how you're going to deliver the content, your content. I want to see that. And otherwise, if you're guys interested to join our Savvy Action Tech Entrepreneur, where you're going to learn how to create your content, how to repurpose your content, how to sell your content, you know, like for example, if you want to learn, you figure out, like, I'm going to deliver my content with the challenges. Challenges is, if you really want to create profitable challenge, it's not just you hopping in on the video, deliver the content, and boom, you have the sales. Things are unfortunately not working that way. So, for example, in our academy, I have the whole course, Content Creation Challenge. I think it's like launch your course with the challenges or something like this. But I literally breaking down what you need to do pre-launch and launching and challenges. And post-launching, the same with the webinars, the same with the video training. For those people who have their own Facebook group and they're like, okay, I want to make money with my Facebook group, I want to start my Facebook group, I want to grow my Facebook group, I want to boost engagement in my Facebook group, and I want to create connections with my followers in my Facebook group, and I want to sell my service in my Facebook group. So we have the whole course about the Facebook groups, literally what to do and how to do to using your Facebook group as the passive income or active income in your business. So every aspect that you need to know in our in your business, we usually have some kind of course in our academy. I teach you how to spread your word, building your visibility, building your followers on social media. I teach you what to do and how to do step by step, like A to Z. We have the workbooks, we have templates, email marketing. For example, if you decide to use YouTube to grow your business, from YouTube you want to grow your list, right? The same with with blogging, you want to grow your list. So then we have marketing, email marketing and email funnels, and I literally teach you, this is email that you need to send, this is what you need to write inside of the email. I have the templates, I have everything, like the structure of the emails, to make sure that people open your emails, to make sure that people click on your emails, to make sure that people, you get people schedule the calls with you on through the emails, and you get your one-on-one clients. So we have lots of courses inside of the academy that would help you to literally start growing your business from the beginning. If you're just totally new to social media, you have the idea, like, okay, I have idea, I have some, maybe have some followers, and then later I want to grow my business. And we have the whole that system, step-by-step system, like courses, step-by-step courses, what to do and how to do. You're gonna learn how to create your first course, and how to create your course, how to launch your course, how to sell your course. We're gonna teach you how to repurpose in your content. So it's not just like, our academy is not just like one or two courses. We have the list of the different courses that will help you with the different aspect. So it doesn't matter where you in your business, if you're not not making your consistent six-figure business, then our academy is for you. It's not overnight success. Every strategy, structure and strategy that I share inside of our academy, I tested on my own and I share it with you, and I encourage you implement that. Remember, learn, implement and analyze in your business. On top of that, if you don't want just, you know, get all the access to all the courses, if you want to get support from me, every month in our academy we have a bonus, a private Facebook group. When first of all, you can share your questions inside of the group and you will get from me, not from my team, but you're gonna get from me specific answer for your questions. On top of that, we have monthly business Q&A. We have a guest speakers every month. So if, for example, I'm not perfect, like I'll give you example, I'm not perfect with English. Duh, we all know that by now. However, I invite guest speakers who actually bring their presentation, they bring their mini courses to our academy, and they literally share everything what to do and how to do. We have a copywriters, couple copywriters presentations out there. We have this month, we had Instagram, epic Instagram training that the girl was teaching you guys to start her Instagram and bring us to the 16 followers, right? 16,000 followers, whatever that's, 16K. Whatever, next month we're gonna teach you guys YouTube. The presentation that from guest speaker that next month gonna share with you, she's gonna start how to start your YouTube account to the point how to make money with your YouTube account. So basically in our academy, yes, you're gonna get training from A to Z, what to do and how to do to grow your business. And then on top of that, we have monthly Q&A, which is I answer all your questions and I help you with the steps and the strategy to grow your business. We have a guest speakers on the different topics, and you require the topic, we deliver the guest speakers. So we have guest speakers on top. We have monthly workshops. So for example, by the way, those people who are in academy, next Tuesday we're gonna have a workshop about virtual summit. So I'm gonna share with you A to Z how to create your virtual summit, how to launch your virtual summits, and how to grow your list with the virtual summits, what you need to do and what you not need to do. So we have lots of different trainings. So if you have questions about the academy part, if you like, it sounds interesting, but I'm not sure if it will fit me or fit my business, please shoot me a message and I will be answering. I will be honest. If you, for example, selling physical product, then I will be like, girl, I'm sorry, our academy is for launching your service. So I will be honest with you. So if you have questions related to the academy part, if you're not sure if you have trainings out there, not trainings, if it will fit your business or not fit your business, shoot the message and I will be honestly answering with you, share maybe behind the scene and share with you like what is inside and kind of get clarity, is that for you or not for you. Otherwise, guys, I will see you tomorrow and we will mapping up your content, because by now you already have all this knowledge, right? And I want to organize and put everything in one picture, so you will walk away from the point when like, okay, I finally know when need to show up, what kind of content need to deliver, what's the goal behind of the content, and what kind of results I want to achieve with my content. All of that will be putting everything together in like in one puzzle part, everything together. And then on day number 5, I'm gonna share with you guys the common mistakes that I see that people make when they share the content. Because let's be honest, I share with you tips and strategy, how to create the content, how to show up with your content, but at the end of the day, people are making mistakes. I make mistakes with my content when I started, and it took me a while to figure out why my content is not giving me results what I want to. So I'm gonna share on the day number 5 what the mistakes you need to avoid if you want to create the powerful content and want to get results with your content. Remember the content that convert to sales, convert to grow your list, convert to followers, whatever the goal you set on a day number yesterday, so it's day number two. So on the day number five, we're gonna cover what mistakes you need to avoid to make sure that your content is working for you. So if you have the questions, you're welcome to share it in our Facebook group, Savvy Action Taker Entrepreneur. If you did not sign for the challenge, make sure you sign for the challenge, because you still get email with the replay of all the videos. And join our academy if you are interested to grow your business from the scratch to the six figure without getting broke. And that's it. If you're not sure about the questions about the academy, shoot me a message and I will be answering. Okay, guys? I love you so much. Thank you so much for being here, and looking forward to see your homework. Bye for now.